Taskade has so many great features to help us work more efficiently. So in today's video, I'm sharing with you 7 of my favorite tips and tricks so you can get the most out of Taskade, whether you use it for project management, as your personal to-do list, or maybe just for brainstorming. There's something special which is going to help you work smarter in today's video. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. Now, tip number 1 has to do with something that we often overlook but can help us save so much time, and that has to do with bulk actions, whether that's a bulk movement or maybe bulk editing or bulk formatting. Taskade makes it really easy for us to do all 3. So for example, maybe I forgot to put these 3 items that are actually meant to be in the details down below. Most project management systems will force you to do these things 1 at a time, but not here in Taskade. All I need to do is highlight that section. I can drag it down here, and now it's a part of my details section down below. How about this subsection down here? Maybe I want to have this indented. Well, just simply highlight and hit my tab key, and I can move it over. The other great thing about bulk actions is that we can apply bulk editing as well. So if I want to format everything under this task heading, all I need to do is select it, and I can bold all of this text. I can even add some highlighting color or underlines if I want, just to make things stand out as well. So don't forget to bulk move, bulk edit, or bulk format right here within Taskade. Now, tip number 2 has to do with making use of video conferencing right here from within Taskade. Rather than jumping out of the application and going and finding a video conferencing link, all I need to do is come up here and hit the toggle chat button. So if I don't want to be limited to just a text-based conversation, I can come up here to the right-hand corner and select start call. Now, anyone who is invited or a part of this project will have access to this particular meeting. I'm going to select join meeting here and turn my camera on, and here we are, ready to go. I can collaborate with others. We can all see what's going on here on the screen in front of us, and it even has other features such as screen sharing. So if I want to share something else, I can do so and do it all right here from within Taskade. Now, tip number 3 has to do with one of my favorite features, and that is the multiple views in which we can view our information. You're probably most used to using the list view, which is often the default view for our projects. However, at the top of the screen, we have 4 different additional views in which we can make use of. The first one is a board view. So if you like a more Kanban style view, or maybe just seeing your work in different columns, this may be the view for you. Next, we have an action view, which is actually actionable. What I love about the action view is that there's so many different things that we have here at our fingertips, or should I say our cursor tips, including the new timer feature. But if I want to collapse something, I can still do so here and just focus on the task that I'm worried about. I can still use everything here, such as the checkbox feature, and work through almost more of a spreadsheet or a column and rows format. But if you want something even more flexible, you might love the mind map feature here, which will turn your data into a mind map, or if you love to brainstorm, you may want to start your next mind map right here within Taskade. Last but not least, we have an organizational chart view, which is essentially turning that mind map view on its side, but the nice thing is that it's still functional. It doesn't squeeze everything across, so I don't have to be scrolling far to the right. I can see everything here based on my different headers, the things that I have chosen in my other views. The other nice thing, for example, if I like this action view and I want it to be my default, all I need to do is click it a second time, and now you can see I have this little star beside it. What that means is that every time that I open up this particular project, it will bring me back to my default view. Now, if I want to deselect it, all I need to do is select it one more time, and maybe I want to come back here to the list. I'm going to hit that one twice, and now this will be my default view. So no more do I have to start a project or reload my software and go to my preferred view. I can let Taskade know what I like, and it will remember it for me. Now, another great feature, which has saved my skin more than once, is the ability to quickly review any changes and version history, but also to be able to restore my projects to any point in time. Here in the top right-hand corner, we can click on the project history, and this is going to give us a running history of the most recent events. So here we can see some of the things that we've completed, some of the things that I've edited within the last 30 minutes. Now, I can continue to load more if I want to, but up here at the top, we can also click the version history. And what I love about this screen, what I love about the way that Taskade has laid this out, is not only can I see all of my versions here on the right-hand side, many of them by the minute, right? Because it's going to save that version depending on what has changed or what has been edited. But I also get to see the changes on the left-hand side. So as I toggle through different changes, I can go and see, well, which one is it that I want? This is the one that I'd like to restore. I can preview it here live in front of me before I select the restore point. An incredibly helpful feature, so you're confident that you're restoring your project to the one that you want. Now, the next tip in our list has to do with easily sharing our projects or workspaces with others, including with those who have no experience with Taskade at all. Here in the top right of our screen, we have this large invite button. And when I select it, we have two options available to us. We can either invite someone to our entire workspace, right? This can be a collection of different projects, or we can just invite them to a particular project. So in this case, I'm going to select the individual project. Now, we've got a few different ways in which we can share this project, either via email or username. We can send them an invite link, which I'm going to choose in this case, because perhaps I want to share it with someone who I know is not familiar with Taskade, or who is not maybe just interested in using Taskade for this particular project. That's fine. Maybe I've done the brainstorming, I've been doing the work here in an application that I love, but I just want to share that information with others. I can either allow them to be an editor, a checker, or what I'm going to choose in this case is a viewer, so that they can only comment and chat, but they cannot edit the project. I'm going to select that and then copy this link, and now I can paste it wherever I need to. So quick and easy, a variety of different ways in which we can share our projects or workspaces with others. The number six tip on our list has to do with using tags within our project so that we can easily filter or find the information that we're looking for. So for example, you can already see that I've got a couple of tags here that I'm using. I've got finance up here, and I've got a few more that are labeled both marketing and finance. Let's say that this video conferencing setup is a task for the marketing team. So all I'm going to do is hit that hashtag, and I can either enter it in manually myself, or I can choose from one of my existing tags. Now, whenever I want to go and find or group these tags together, I can just use the search function up top. In this case, I'm going to search for everything that is marketing and hit enter. And now everything is going to be brought back that has that marketing tag. What I especially like is that it keeps my different blocks and my different subheadings open. When I've used tag searches in other project management tools, often they will just tell me the individual line item. And maybe in some small print, I have to look to see where exactly does that exist. But the nice thing here, let's go back and let's search for finance as an alternative here. So I'm going to search finance in this case. I know exactly that this task is under the background section. It's also under the number one goal. And this particular task is under next step. So it keeps it nice and clear. And I can do this search within my multiple views as well. So don't forget to use tags to help you order your various tasks and your brainstorming ideas. Now, the last tip that I have for you today is to make use of the Taskade Chrome extension. With the Taskade Chrome extension installed, you have several different options as to what you would like to see happen when a new tab or window is opened. So, for example, I can choose that when I open up a new tab here, it's going to open up my last project here within Taskade. So let's try it out. I'm going to hit that plus button, and automatically I'm brought to the last project I was involved in. This can be very helpful, especially if you find it hard to focus in and stay on top of your most important tasks and projects. But those aren't the only options available to you. You can choose to have the dashboard appear, or a brand new project, or maybe your calendar so you can see all your due dates. Of course, you don't have to choose any of these options and just choose the default if you wish, but this can be a great way to remind yourself as to what you should be working on next. Now, as an added bonus for watching all the way to the end, I'd like to upgrade your Taskade workspace for free. All you need to do is use the Simpletivity coupon code and you'll receive a 100% off lifetime discount to your upgraded Taskade workspace. Please note, this coupon is only valid for the first 1,000 users, so if you want to get the most out of your Taskade account, be sure to use that coupon code. You can also see the link in the description below for more details. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.